5 goddamn months. Finally back. Jeez, where did I keep those things? Okay, let's start it here.
We are saddened to report the death of Diane Reed, the only daughter of the Reed family. Her body was found in the bathroom of their mansion at 8 o'clock this morning. The rest of the family was getting ready for breakfast at the time. Her body was found by her father, after which he immediately notified emergency services. An autopsy later showed that Diane had been dead for at least a few hours. It was ruled a suicide. It is believed she used an old towel the family kept in the kitchen to suffocate herself. The reasoning behind her suicide is, as of yet, unclear. She was so young and innocent, always happy, always smiling. I can't believe this. Life seems to hurt the most innocent souls, said one neighbor of the family after the tragedy. Our hearts go out to the Reed family during these difficult times.
Robert Wright of Clover Springs was reported missing last night. He left his high school friend's house 3 days ago when he was alleged to have crossed the plant field near Route 96. Since then, all trace of him was lost, making him the third high schooler missing in 2 weeks in Clover Springs. Clover High School has temporarily closed its doors. The police advise citizens not to leave their houses after dark and to be careful.
Yo guys, it's Dean, back again with another video. Sorry for the long break. I didn't have time to record anything. Family problems, school, you know. But we are back with a big one. I really had to dig to get these recording. But let's quit the chit-chat and get down to business. Clover Springs, quiet town in Washington, green grass, fresh air, black coffee. In there, Reed's perfect family. Respected, wealthy. Yet the daughter offs herself out of nowhere. And after that, things get really weird in that small town. Few people disappear, including the rest of the Reed's family. Father, mother, and son simply vanished. No trace. After a year, the town is basically abandoned. All moved out. I went online and stumbled upon this interesting theory, in which Diane's father was responsible for those missing teenagers. Some sources state that Diane was heavily bullied in school, and that would be the reason why she... So the father, seeking revenge, chose those teens, buried them somewhere, and then flies to Cuba. I don't know. It's just a theory. There isn't much information about the Reeds anyways. Especially about the girl. She must have never left the house or something. Well, now their house is a dope urbex attraction. And probably some satanic bullshit place. But that's every abandoned building. And also every forest. We are here. The main road has been closed many years, so I had to park the car a little further away. And let me tell you, those trees are creepy. It feels like they're looking at me. Okay, let's take a look inside. Here we are. This place almost didn't age at all. And the furniture's all messed up and the windows are nailed, but other than that, pretty good. The mansion was built in the 1930s, and it seems that three different families lived here. Reeds were the last. Remember, you always gotta watch out for homeless people in these places. I once heard about a guy jumped by a hobo with a crowbar in some abandoned railway station. If I had to rank what I don't want to experience while urbexing, hobos with crowbars are a close second. First, are probably collapsing floors or hobos with knives. May she rest in peace. Thank you. This must be the dad's office. Guy's name was Clint Reed. Couldn't really find much information about him, only that he was apparently a lawyer. I tried to interview some of their neighbors, but they weren't really helpful, most of them, at least. They didn't remember any details, as if they had some kind of collective amnesia. Diane, the daughter, she got very sick at one point. Something with her spine. She got really deformed. The pain was so intense, her parents were locking her up in a room just to muffle her screams. Room. And that is where the parents slept. I think. All the interior was left behind. Wow. Okay, so the brother was a ventriloquist, and that's probably his doll. Still in a good condition. Really messy in here. I suspect this was Diane's old room. You know me. I don't give up this easily. Gotta find the code. Thank you. Did you hear that? Jeez, you scared me. Yeah, I'm fine. What's up? Shit. I understand. I'll do it as soon as I get back to the car. I understand. Bye. electricity tends to act strangely in these houses. Yeah. Smell.
Thank you.
like there's a secret passage downstairs. Holy shit!
The body of 22-year-old Judy Flores was found in the river this morning. The girl fell to her death from a
6-foot bridge
into the rocks. First responders declared her dead at the scene. The tragedy is being investigated as a possible suicide.
He is in the hallway.
That she has been battling depression for a long time.
Thank you. Hello?
Find you. Don't look at them.
Hello? Hello?